Hello, Anya Gassi Hall. Bienvenido a mi canal. Today's experiment is about purification of organic solids by recrystallization. Recrystallization is one of the several methods employed in purifying an organic solid. Now, in recrystallization, we need to know the best solvent or suitable solvent. Now, the suitable solvent is the one in which the organic compound is relatively insoluble at room temperature, but soluble at higher temperature. So I have here with me my crude sample. This is my crude sample. No, it is not pure. As you can see, it's like blackish in color. So I'm going to purify this. Now, I don't know the best solvents to use. I don't know. So I have here with me four solvents, and I'm going to perform the solubility test to be able to get my suitable solvent for this practical. So let me quickly take you through the solvent. I have here acetone, petroleum ether, methanol, and water. So I'm going to fetch small amount of the crude sample in each of the test tubes here. Now the solvents are four, so I have here four test tubes. So when I fetch small amount in each of the test tubes, then I is going to perform the solubility tests. Okay. Because we are searching for the best solvent, we don't need to weigh. So you are not going to weigh, just small amounts in each of the test tubes. Now, as you can see, I've labeled the test tubes as well, so that I don't get confused. Okay. Okay, so Isaac is going to perform the solubility test. So he's starting with...
It's methanol.
Yes, methanol. So Isaac is starting with methanol. Okay. So he's going to put just few drops of it. I'll quickly cover the methanol because it's very volatile. So the solvent should, the compound should be relatively insoluble at low temperature. So you have to check to see if you will see any residue. If you don't see any residue, then it means this solvent is not a good solvent. So Isaac will shake for us to see if there are any residue at the bottom of the test tube. So as we can see, our crude has dissolved completely in the methanol, so which means methanol is not a good solvent. It's not a good solvent. So we go to the next solvent. Okay, so the next solvent is water. And I have here with me distilled water. So we are going to test it. Can you shape for us? So as you can see, I can see some traces of the crude at the bottom. So we are going to heat it and see if it will dissolve. Because a best solvent is supposed to dissolve the compound at higher temperatures. So we are going to heat it and see if it will dissolve. So I'll give the test tube holder to Isaac for him to heat it in the water bath. Isaac, can you please heat it for us?
Okay.
To see if the sample will dissolve completely. Alright. So we are heating it to see if everything will dissolve. As I said earlier, the best solvent for recrystallization is usually the one in which the compound is relatively insoluble at low temperatures, but soluble at higher temperatures. So we are heating to check if it will be soluble. So, Isaac, can you shake and lift it up for us to see?
Hey, Lawrence.
Okay, so we are still waiting for everything to dissolve. Now, there is something that I want to say, that if the bulk of the crude sample dissolves but a residue remains, do not add more solvent in an effort to dissolve the residue. So we are going to check and see. So the sample has dissolved, but what is at the bottom is the residue. Is the residue. Yes, but the crude sample has dissolved. So what is left there is residue. So which means that water is a suitable solvent. Okay. So Isaac, if you can put it here for us so that we move to the next solvent. Okay, so the next solvent is acetone. Okay, so I have here the acetone. So Isaac is adding the acetone to our food sample. He's adding more. Can you please close for me? Thank you. So let's shake and see. Oh, so acetone has dissolved the crude sample completely. So acetone is not a good solvent, as you can see. We cannot even see the crude sample at the bottom of the test tube. So acetone is not a good solvent, or is not a suitable solvent. So we'll go ahead with our last solvent. Yeah. So we are moving to our last solvent, which is petroleum ether. Okay, so Isaac is going to do that for us. Yeah. Okay. Yeah, I can see. Yes, I can see the sample at the bottom. I can see. So which means petroleum ether is likely to be a good solvent as well, just like water. So we are going to heat it a little bit to see if all the crude sample will dissolve. So Isaac is going to do that for us. So Isaac is doing the heating. Okay, so now it's like we have two best solvents, which is water and petroleum ether. Water and petroleum ether. So let's check Yeah, can you see? I can't see. Yes, yeah, so everything has dissolved. Can you heat it a little bit more? So can you bring it out for us to see? Yes, everything has dissolved. Yeah, everything has dissolved. So you can put it down. Okay. Alright, so now we have two best solvents. We have two best solvents, water and petroleum ether. Now, how do we choose one? When the suitable solvent is two or more, there are some factors we need to consider. There are some four factors, and one of them is the availability of the solvent. The other one is the cost, toxicity, and the volatility. So these are the four factors to consider when the suitable solvent is two or more. Now when we compare water and petroleum ether, water is not toxic as compared to petroleum ether because we drink water. So obviously it's not toxic. And when we come to the cost, now water is less costly than the petroleum ether. Petroleum ether is very, very expensive. Even 2.5 liters of petroleum ether will cost almost 400 cedis. So when you compare the cost, water is less costly. Now when we come to the availability, water is always available because we drink it. But petroleum ether is not available because it's toxic. You can only get it in certified shops. Now when we come to the volatility, petroleum ether is very volatile as compared to water. As for water, you can leave it open and it will not evaporate. But for petroleum ether, when you open it, you have to quickly close it. So when we compare these two solvents, the best solvent to use is water. It's water. So we are going to use water. Even though petroleum ether is also a good solvent, we are not going to use it. We are going to use water based on the factors, the four factors I mentioned. Okay. So we are going to start with the experiment itself. Now that we know our suitable solvent. So now I have here with me a beaker. So you are going to fetch small amount of the food sample into the beaker, then you dissolve it with the water, which is our suitable solvent. Now because we are using it for demonstration, we are not going to weigh the food sample. So just fetch a little bit, add last one. Okay, so Isaac is going to dissolve it with the water. Now, this cannot hold the beaker, so we are going to use a tong. So whilst Isaac is swirling, I'll quickly go and bring a tong and use it to hold the beaker whilst we are heating. Can you try that and see if you can use it to hold the beaker? You can hold it like this. Okay. What about this way? You have to be careful. Okay. So now we are doing the heating. because we want everything to dissolve completely. So you have to remember that a good solvent is the one in which the compound is relatively insoluble at low temperatures but soluble at high temperatures. So whilst we are eating, we are expecting that the food sample should dissolve completely because it's in hot water. So whilst Isaac is eating, I'm trying to fold the filter paper. My funnel is ready, my conical flask is also ready. So you have to heat it for some few minutes. As you are eating, you have to check if everything has dissolved. Now, before we purify an organic compound, first we are supposed to determine the melting point of the crude. Yes, I forgot to say it. But the first thing we're supposed to do is to determine the melting point. But we didn't do it because it takes a lot of time. So when you want to purify any organic solid, you have to determine the melting point of the crude. Then after purifying, you determine the melting point of the purified sample. Then you try to compare the two. Okay, so Isaac is stirring. Yeah, he's trying to swirl. Yeah, that's the right word. Swirling. Now, if you don't have a tongue to hold the beaker, you can use a napkin to hold the beaker. Yes. Okay, so has it dissolved? Sorry.
Yes, please.
Everything has dissolved. So can we filter now?
Yes, yes.
So we have to filter it whilst it is hot. Okay, so Isaac is going to pour it. So whilst it's filtering, can you still please put it on fire? Okay. Oh wow, the crystals are already forming at the bottom. If you can see, that is the purified sample looking like whitish in color. We have not cooled it, but it has started forming. Yeah, that is it. We are supposed to cool it in an ice bath for the pure crystals to precipitate out. But as you can see, the crystals are already forming. Okay, so Isaac, if it's okay, you can bring it, continue with it. So Isaac is going to rinse the beaker with water. We heat the water and we pour it back in. You can see that the water we used is less. That's why we are having more of the residue. So add more water, then we heat it and add it. Oh wow, it's very nice. Oh, my cameraman is nodding his head. Oh my goodness. And he's smiling. Okay, so Isaac has rinsed the beaker. Yes. So he has rinsed it with enough water. He's heating it. Then we pour the water in there. We add it to the crude. Oh, one of my video directors, Efo Felix, came here. He was watching us and he's admiring our work. One of these days, I'll invite Efo to come and join us. I've been mentioning his name, but it's like nobody knows Efo Felix. One day, I'll pull him here. He's laughing at me. Okay. So, can we add the water now if it is hot? Add it. Can you heat it? How's the water? The filtrate, we are waiting for it to filter, if you can heat the water, because we don't want it to be cold. Oh, this thing is very nice. We have not cooled it yet, but see, let me bring it for my lovely viewers to see. Yeah. Alright. Oh, please add it to it. Okay, so whilst we are waiting for it to filter, Isaac will quickly go to the fridge and bring the ice block so that we can get our ice bath whilst I do the monitoring. Okay, so we are done filtering. So we are going to cool it for more crystals to form. So now, this is the impurities. We don't need this. So this is the impurities. Let me show you how it looks. So this is the impurities. We don't need this. So we will discard this one. So this contains our pure sample. So I'm going to induce more crystals by placing it in an ice bath, okay? So, as I've been doing in other videos, scratching the bottom to induce more crystals. Okay. You watch me as I do my thing. I enjoy doing this a lot. So, Isaac, please hold the filter paper for me. I think it's okay now. We can filter our purified sample. Okay, are you done?
Yes, yes.
Okay. Isaac is done, so now I can transfer my purified sample here. So let's wait for everything to filter, then I'll show you our purified sample. Okay, so we are done filtering. So I'll bring it out for you to see. Okay. So this is the purified sample. This is the purified. So this is what we started with. This is the crude. This is the crude. And after purifying, this is the end product. This is the end product. So this is how we purify an organic solid or an organic compound by recrystallization. So now we have to dry this in the oven or under the sun. Then we determine the melting point of the pure sample. Then we compare the two melting points. So I said that before you purify the crude, you have to determine its melting point. Then after purifying, you dry and determine the melting point as well. Then you compare the two. But I'm not going to dry it right now because it's going to waste a lot of time. So this is how you purify an organic compound by recrystallization. I hope you enjoyed today's video. And please, if you did, please give my video a thumbs up, okay? And thank you so much for watching. Please stay safe and take good care of yourselves. Isaac, would you like to say something to your fans? Come on, say something to them.
Greetings to all chemistry students. Chemistry student of the University of Education, Winneba.
Okay.
Family and friends.
Okay.
Bye.
Bye-bye. So we see you in our next video. Ciao.
Bye.